In just more than 24 hours, Boeing Starliner spacecraft test mission will blast off from the Cape to the International Space Station.
Our Scott Heidler is out on the Space Coast and has been tracking all of the details leading up to this launch. So, Scott, how are things looking for tomorrow?
Starliner crew capsule is all set for its test mission to the International Space Station. Now, this will be Boeing's third attempt at this. They had a mission in 2019 that was cut short, and then one last summer that never even got off the ground.
A NASA briefing Wednesday painting a positive picture for the Thursday launch. Three NASA astronauts on hand involved in the testing process for Starliner. They're not going up, but they've played a big role in setting up this OFT-2 mission.
We are more than thrilled to be here. And we're also very, very jealous because this is human spaceflight, and Rosie, the mannequin, is the one that gets to take the trip instead of us.
Rosie the Rocketeer will be strapped into the commander's seat to act as a ballast, but also collect data through a multitude of sensors. The orbital test flight is critical to the certification process, so that Starliner will soon be joining SpaceX's Dragon capsule in bringing crews to low Earth orbit.
2, 1, 0.
Dragon's already been doing it since 2020, but as Boeing wants a successful mission, NASA needs Starliner to start flying as quickly as possible, too.
And you need two companies that can provide that redundancy to get people and cargo to the International Space Station.
Starliner will be docked to the International Space Station for about 4 to 5 days. It'll undock and then about a day later deorbit for a touchdown in a New Mexico desert. Reporting live on the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.
Scott, thank you. We are counting down to the rocket launch tomorrow. Tune in to West 2 to watch the launch live on TV and online inside of West.com.